Hi, so this is to show you how to replace any of the internal parts of the Reef LED. First thing you want to do, make sure that we are not connected to the DC power supply, and it's best to work on some kind of soft mat so that you don't do any damage to the unit. Firstly, remove the top cover by clicking it in the corners and place that on one side. Then we're going to remove the four screws. First two screws we're going to remove completely. Second two screws, just release the threads, but don't take them out. And then we're just going to tap it lightly to release the front cover. Taking a flathead screwdriver, just gently prise it open. And then just put this on one side. Now I'm going to show you how you remove and replace the LED array. In the spare parts pack, you get two parts. You get the LED array itself and a set of replacement screws should you need it. Probably you won't. We'll just put that on one side for now, because we can reuse the original screws. When you open the pack, you will see that there is a thermal transfer pad on the back of the LED array. This is a soft material. Make sure that it doesn't get damaged, and don't put it that side down on your work surface, because it might get damaged or stick to the surface. Make sure also that you do not touch any of this area of the LED array, because it could cause some damage. So let's just put this back in its box on one side for a second. We remove the four screws that are holding the LED array in position. As I'm sure you are aware, the aluminium here is a heat sink. There's a lot of heat generated by the LED while it's working, and that thermal pad is there to make sure that all of the heat from the LED is transferred to the aluminium, so that it keeps the LEDs running at the right temperature. If we do not do that, the LEDs will in fact get damaged and stop working. Okay, now what we need to try and do is raise the LED array without damaging those connector pins. So it's best to use some kind of a scraper in order to do that, to gently raise the array just on the corners. And that's perfect. Now we're going to slide it back. As we can see, this time we've managed to do it without damaging at all the thermal pad. Before we place a new one, you will want to take a scraper and remove any of that excess material that is left behind on the aluminium. Normally you will take your replacement one and put it in position. There is nothing wrong with the one that I removed. This is just for demonstration, so I'm going to put it back. I'm going to carefully align. See if we can show that a bit better. You're going to align the pins with the holes in the electronic boards. Push it back in until the holes of the array are aligned with the holes in the heatsink. Press down on all sides and then return the screws. Best is just to make sure that everything is aligned properly, is to screw them in just a little bit, don't tighten them. Put in all four screws. And when all four screws are in position, we can now tighten them one at a time. There we have it. Everything is firm. I was able to complete the whole process without touching LED array. At the end, don't forget to return the fan connector. And that's it, we're done. To continue, place the cover back on top and we can return the screws. Top cover just clips back into place. And there we are ready to go back into operation.